Casey's out here with Miriam West. We're at Union Square. This woman is part of an artist movement. They are so brave and dynamic. Tell me, why are you here?
Here as a protest today. This is an illegal spot to vend. So what we've done is we set up the table and we have a display only not for sale sign, which is totally legal, even though they've tried to stop us. I got a ticket for one day last Saturday. Tony, my partner, was out and they tried to shut him down. They tried to bluff him and say, well, we changed the rules on Thursday. We had a big meeting. So Tony said, well, then you're going to have to summons me. And they walked away and never came back.
Okay, so, who's we? When they say we, who's we?
The Parks Department.
Okay, so the Parks Department and Mayor Bloomberg. Mayor Bloomberg's supposed to be a great patron of the arts, but...
Yeah, he claims to be a patron of the arts, yet he's destroying street artists' rights. I believe that he probably only likes artists who are famous and rich already.
Correct.
Great. So, you know, he's destroying the street artists' rights. We're just trying to make an honest living out here. We have sales tax IDs. We pay taxes. Well, we didn't have to have a permit to sell in the parks because we have a federal court ruling that says we are allowed under the First Amendment to display and sell our work in public parks.
So they're violating your First Amendment rights.
They certainly are, yes. But they're claiming it's because we're a public safety hazard, we congest the park, and we ruin the aesthetics of the park.
It's hard to believe that the park is, that you are adding to congestion, because looking around today, I see the farmers market, and on many days you could see events like for Best Buy and for private companies. So how could that be?
I don't know how that can be. You know, one clip of Benepi, and he's saying, you can't even see the fountain, and you can't even see Gandhi because the artists are in the way. But if you look down there, the tents cover up Gandhi.
Yeah.
And there's a huge truck blocking the fountain. A lot of the farmers block the benches, so you can't even have access to the benches. They put their inventory there. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love the farmers market.
Yeah, we do too. We love the Parks Department, but we just don't want them oppressing us.
Exactly. You can't put a set of rules to one group and not to another.
Right.
If we're congesting the park, so is the farmers market, so is the holiday market, so are all the corporate promotions, so are the chess players who gamble out here. It's pretty crazy.
Yeah, you just showed me today proof that the artists are not congesting and blocking the fountain, but in fact it's the farmers market. Thank you. Here's your artwork. Tell me about your art.
This is my true artwork. This is my heart and soul. These are assemblage boxes.
Mm-hmm.
They all have a little story behind them. I named them all. They're all one of a kind, original pieces.
And what's the name of this one?
This one has most of the pieces in it are vintage or antique watch pieces, and I named it Time Discovers Truth, and that is a quote by Seneca, and I hope that it's true, that time discovers truth, because I want the truth to be known about not only this situation, but about situations throughout the world where people are being oppressed. The people with money get to do whatever they want.
Correct.
Screw the little people. Who cares? They don't have a voice. So hopefully this piece is the truth.
Thank you. That's beautiful. Who made this?
This, actually, one of the artists who used to set up here, his name is David Baloff. He used to make, or he still makes t-shirts, but he has stopped coming to the park because the spots that they've designated for us are so horrible. You can't even make a living.
They
put the spots on the outskirts of the park.
And so unemployment's unbelievably high, and here you have Mike Bloomberg, and he's, who's that? Is that Adrian Benepi?
That's Adrian Benepi. So this is the puppet and the puppeteer and his puppet.
Yeah, Christine Quinn's another one of his puppets.
It seems like he just wants rich people to live in New York City.
Yeah.
And wants to get rid of the middle class and the poor.
Yes.
We can't afford to live here anymore.
Right. He's ticketing people up to their eyeballs, and it's all over New York, and people are fed up. Thank you for your courage for coming out here.
Thank you, Susanna. You're incredible.
Thank you. You are. You are.